Hello, my name is Christine and I run a vintage shop called Prima Treasures on Etsy. Today I wanted to talk about clocks. I have two different clocks here on my table, and the reason I wanted to go over this is because I think for a lot of people, when you think about antique clocks, you're thinking about this type of clock right here on the right. Now, this clock has a key to wind it up, and it's got holes here. You put the key in there and then you wind it, and then inside, my door is not working. It's got a pendulum and some gears and springs and things like that, and oopsie, I've abused the door. And it just ticks and ticks and ticks. It's a mechanical clock. It has gears and winding, and that's how it works to keep time. Nowadays, we have quartz clocks, which are, you know, very tiny mechanisms, and they run on batteries, and that's pretty much what we're used to seeing for clocks. But the quartz clock was only invented in 1980, so between the time frame when this was the most common clock and the quartz was the most common clock, there's a good 50-60 years of clock usage and clock manufacturing that seems to have kind of been lost. A lot of people don't really know what would have happened in between. So that's the type of clock I wanted to focus on. This type of clock here stopped being the most common clock around the 1930s. So between the 1930s and the 1980s, you had 50 years of, well, I don't know. So that's what I wanted to talk about. The clock you see on the left is that type of clock that they would have used during that middle period before quartz became popular. And it's an electric clock. Now, at the very beginning, electric clocks were essentially this design, but with electricity instead of winding. So it still had the gears, it still had the pendulum, but instead of having to wind it all the time, there was an electric current that went to it that would provide that, you know, power to power all of the gears and whatnot. Around 1930 is when they started moving towards clocks that did not require winding. And so that's really what we would think of as an electric clock. The first clock of that sort was invented around 1918, but really, you know, a lot of homes didn't have electrical power at that point in time, so it was mostly throughout the 1930s that this type of electric clock would have become more commonplace in people's homes. So essentially what you have here is, and I hope you can see, it has a power cord, so it required to be plugged into an outlet in order to power it. And the thing I find interesting about these electric clocks is that they were often very diverse types of designs, because again, they weren't relying on all this mechanical hardware to make it work. It just had a simple, you know, box inside of it that was used to keep the time. So all of this extra stuff you see here would have been just to make it more interesting looking. The other upside to an electrical clock that we don't see nowadays, and that's why this one is kind of a good example of that, is because they were using electricity, they could do more elaborate things with it. And that included things like lights on top of it. Sometimes they would have moving pieces to it, little mechanical bits that would, for example, this guy, his hand would probably have moved and made it look like he was pulling on the reins for the horse. So they were animated to a certain extent, or they could be. And I feel like this was kind of the heyday of that sort of design where they were thinking, well, we have electricity now, what can we do with it? So the fun thing about stuff like this is that you get all of these interesting, I would say, sculpted aspects to the clock. It's not just a functional item anymore whose primary purpose is to show you the time and to keep time. Now it can be something decorative. So they would have clocks like this that would go on your mantle, like this one would have, and that would provide visual interest as well, so an aesthetic, not just functional. And then they would also make clocks that could go on your wall, and that's kind of for those of you who are familiar with these mid-century starburst and sunburst clocks, that's another one of the things that they were able to achieve, is the fact that you could put a large clock on a wall and turn it into a wall display where it had, you know, design elements to it and visual impact. So we don't really see clocks like these anymore. In fact, in some ways, clocks have completely left our homes because we have our phones to tell us what time it is. But for a while there, during this period, the 30s through the 80s, clocks could actually function as a statement piece of sorts or an accent piece. And so I wanted to show off this clock just to kind of give you an idea of the sorts of things that were possible during this period that we don't really think about anymore as being, you know, of any meaningful interest. But I've seen a lot of clocks from this period, the 30s, the 40s, the 50s, and, you know, they have a fun novelty look with sculptural designs, and they definitely work very nicely as a decorative part of your decor and not just a clock. So if you're somebody who might have an interest in something like that, maybe you want to bring a clock back into a room, but you don't want it to feel, you know, like it's just there to tell time or it's just there to be functional, you might consider something like this, because a lot of these clocks, because they were plugged in, and the you can see here, the face is fairly small, so it's not a prominent aspect of the overall design, and in the, all of the workings are enclosed inside this case here. So it hasn't had a lot of abuse like an antique clock of this type might have done, because this one you have to open and close the door, it's probably getting dust and gunk in it all the time, it's more likely to have problems because of having to constantly access the inside mechanism and tinker with it when you wind it back up, etc. So this has been enclosed in the case for probably 40, 50 years. It's not getting a lot of dust and gunk in it. Most of the times when we get one, it works. So this one I had to tinker with a little bit, but you can see that the light still functions. I had to replace the chain on his hand. So it's not 100%, but it still looks very cool. And I could easily see that in someone's living room providing a conversation piece for somebody. So I hope this gave you some helpful information, and thank you for watching.